Down, 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 down. enough when we didn't sell so much to the burner. I guess this is it. Don't bother coming in tomorrow.
You don't mean?
You can mean. What? What are they? Green, I'm cold, forget it, kaput!
You can!
Kaput, extinct! I'm closing this god and customer forsaken place!
Mr. Mushnik, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what this world needs is to move in a new direction?
I want to see what I'm trying to say, Mr. Mushnik, and, well, we've talked about it and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you run out back and bring in that strange and interesting new plan you've been working on? You see, Mr. Mushnik, some of these exotic plants Seymour has been tinkering around with are really unusual. And we were found thinking that maybe some of these strange and interesting plants prominently displayed and advertised would attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
They and that internet bizarre.
At least, what kind of a weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of a fly trap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. I gave it my own name, though. I call it an RP2.
RP2?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, then maybe...
Maybe what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't tell me.
Excuse me, I couldn't have the note in that
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse in the sun about a week ago?
Enjoy dinner.
name.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Crowborn. You're staying right here and taking care of that sick man.
How come it's Fane all the time?
I told you, it keeps doing this to me. The other two is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between us, neither is the Audrey one.
If only I knew what breed it was. What genus? But it's nowhere in the book.
Well, my advice to you, Crowborn, is you better figure it out and fast than what this exotic little beauty's done for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So thanks. Good night.
Your limit.
That's what I'm saying. One day I'm about to close down, and the next Seymour says, put this pen in the window. People want to come and see it. People want to come and see it. Did you ever hear such a crazy idea? Do you know what was even crazier? He was right. Seymour was right. People are flocking to the shop. Business is booming.
So knock it when you've got it.
Well, how'd I do?
Oh, wait, oh,
the address. You didn't mention the address of the shop. How many times have I told you?
I'm sorry. I'm nervous. Where's Audrey? She said she'd be here.
I've got three more radio interviews lined up for tomorrow. Miss Kimbrough will have an exam and what's the picture?
Your favorite Seymour. Who'd have believed it?
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
Forget about your mother. We gotta get down to the agency.
Bravo! Come in, Mr. Mushnick.
Can we have quiet behind the set, please?
Thank you.
Can you say that out loud for Mrs. Shiver?
Mrs. Shiver?
Mrs. Shiver!
Mrs. Shiver, I forgot.
You forgot? You forgot? How could you forget a mom like that? The Shivers are our most important funereal account. A big, enormous family, and the chocolate looks like flies. If we lose that business over this crowbar, you are finished!
Stupid little moron. Why did you have the orphanage?
You know, sometimes I think Mr. Mushnick's too hard on you.
Oh, why am I? After all, I owe him everything. He took me out of Skid Row home from work when I was just a little tyke. Gave me a warm place to sleep, under the counter. Nice things to eat, like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean. And heaven have a Sunday off.
I think you ought to raise your expectations, Seymour. Now that we're getting successful, are we? What with us, why don't you start with some new clothes? Oh, no offense. But what with all the interviews and solo sessions, a big, important experimental bonnet has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste, like you.
Oh, well, I could help you pick things up.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place, like a department store?
Sure.
Tonight?
I can't tonight, I gotta say. But I'd like to go with you another time.
Sure, I'll pencil you in.
How about you go a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates exactly, but a lot of the garden clubs have been calling after me to give lectures.
Gee!
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
That doesn't matter. You have life experience.
Some experience? I don't even know what it's like to fly an airplane.
Oh, me neither.
Orange back to dinner, Cal Johnson.
Me neither.
All right, motorcycle.
Oh, it's lovely, dear. And it's fine. Dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Oh, gee, I'd better go fix my face. My day will be here any minute.
I'm gonna make you mine.
cold.
I'm not here to shout. I'm here to...
Hey, isn't that that plant they're talking about on the news? What do you call it?
LV2.
Cute name.
Catch it.
Nice plant. Big.
Thank you. I made them myself. Now if you don't mind, I'm reading up the...
Is it some kind of new species or something?
That's what they tell me, but you'll have to leave now, we...
Well, why? I don't see why I should leave, but I just wanted to come and talk to you. I'm trying to find Audrey. Let me tell you something, guy. You say you're interesting, right?
Oh, right.
Well, if I was alive, sure as hell wouldn't keep under bow down the schedule going like this. This outcome here could be your ticket to the stars. You could take it to any flower shop in town and name your price. Hey, so me damn well that you partner to get your hands on this.
I don't care. I'm happy here.
He was very loyal.
Somebody's talking to you. I'm telling you, guy, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take this thing with you.
What?
Mushing skid row floors? It's a joke. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
You hear this?
Shouldn't we be leaving now? Sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, doctor. Doctor, sorry, doctor.
You got a dream, master. Well, my bike's outside in Noble Park. What do you think about what I said, H.L.?
Sure, I'll think about it.
You got my handcuffs all ready?
No, I'm right on my back.
Damn, let's go.
Don't think about it?
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnick, and he should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
Just him alone.
Get over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
Seymour left and took his plan.
Before
he started. Broke and starving.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Right back in the gutter, like before the eclipse of the sun.
He's a disgrace to the devil profession.
That's it. Solomon.
Sir?
Here. Take a seat, Seymour. I can wait for later.
You can?
We sure have come a long way since the orphanage.
We sure have, sir.
Please, sir. Don't call me, sir.
What should I call you? You've always liked it before.
How about
Pop?
Sir?
Pop, come on. I've always wanted a son to call me Pop.
A son? Pop?
Sir?
Seymour, how would you like to be my son?
Your son? Mr. Mushnick, sir.
Ah! Seymour, how about it? I need someone to carry on after I'm pushing up the daisies. How about it? Mushnick and son. How about it?
Seymour, I would like to adopt your mission.
You know, I've always really thought of myself as your father.
My father?
So how's about it, Seymour? Let's say I get the lawyers and the signwriters and make you all official.
Gee, a dad of my own. It's what I always dreamed about when I was a kid.
Then say yes, Seymour.
Okay, you persuaded me, Dad.
That's great. You promise?
I promise.
You swear?
I swear.
Oh, not that, Seymour. I gotta get down to my lawyers and get you all signed up. Oh, Seymour.
Yes, sir?
Quit hanging about here and get this place cleaned up.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Seymour. Look after that plant.
I'm his son. I'm his son. Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me. Mushnick's taken.
And someday when I own this whole show, I'll remember I owe it to you. So what if I've been a little bit uneasy and excited the past few weeks? So what if I've had a little bit of my happiness and a few good spells? Well, to me, it's been worth it. Well, I'm a little hungry. I don't know what that stranger should give me a bite to eat. I'll see you in the... Oh boy, here we go again. Look, I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more days to heal, and then... We're starting on that, Dad.
Feed me.
I beg your pardon?
Feed me.
Tui, you talked. You opened your crappy thing and you said...
Feed me, old boy, feed me now.
I can't.
I know,
but you can't get blood from her.
I need some food.
What do you want me to do? Slip my wrist? Look, how about I run down the corner and get you a nice piece of chopped sirloin?
Must be blood.
Sweet, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this. Does it have to be human? Does it have to be mine?
Baby.
Next!
I guess that's me, Dr. Scrubello.
Yeah, toilets.
We met yesterday. Seymour Crowborn?
Oh, of course, the guy with the plants.
Right.
And the band-aids.
Right.
And the gun.
Right.
So, why are you putting gun at me, Seymour?
I...
Are you a little bit nervous about seeing a dentist?
No, I'm not nervous, I...
It's only gonna hurt a little.
You don't understand, I don't want my teeth examined,
Of course you want your teeth examined.
Say ah!
No!
Say ah!
Ah! Ooh, your mouth is a mess, kid. You've got cavities. You've got plaques. You're impacted. You're obsessed.
You're gonna need a complete oral examination. We'll start with that wisdom tooth. We'll just rip that little bugger out of there. What do you say?
I gotta go!
Oh, there's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you ever seen the result of a neglected mouth? Look, Seymour, this could happen to you.
It could?
Oh, no, no, no. This could happen to you.
It could?
Yeah. Unless I take immediate action. Let's get started.
Wait, aren't you going to give me a dose change?
What for? Dose the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
Oh, sorry.
What's that?
That's the drill, Seymour.
But it's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore. It's dirty. Heavy. Dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna really enjoy this. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide. I find a little.
Thank God, I thought you were going to use any.
Oh, the gas isn't for you, Seymour. It's for me. I want to really enjoy this, and I'll find a little giggle gas before you begin. It increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm going to use my facial gas mask for this one. Just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Thank you.
laughed. I fell too.
Way be helping me? Come on in.
One minute, Audrey. I want to show you something.
Can it wait till tomorrow?
It won't take long. I've been shopping around for a new wardrobe like you told me to. And ta-da! What do you think? You don't like it?
No!
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. Just don't cry, please. Look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
I don't know what's come over me. I guess I'm feeling a little under the weather lately.
It's hard, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved when they told me he vanished. It was like a miracle. And not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salts and ace bandages.
Then what's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, I assume that was foul play or some terrible accident of some kind. And it's partly my fault, you see, because secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you shouldn't waste one more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys who give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
Well, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
No, oh, you don't know what happened to me. I've had a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserve a creep like Colin Scruffello. P.T.S. And you know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I work there on my nights off. I'm about making much money. So I put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Isn't that nice? What if I did? Hello, we met.
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person. I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Put that lips away. Show me your face. Clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Sonnet Seymour is standing beside you. No makeup. Don't
part is thickening amongst my employees.
Please, Mr. Daddy.
Don't shoot Mr. Daddy, me, Carl Warren. I wonder if you'd excuse me for a while. Perhaps you'd like to go visit your dentist friend.
That's not very funny, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. He did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy chick.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
Audrey, why don't you run along like he asked? I'll catch up with you later. I'll call for you if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Pretty strange afternoon, son. After my visit to the lawyers, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, it seems they found a Skid Row flyer, which is a Skid Row flyer bag, in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch, and it's stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with? Where are you going?
If you want to get rid of something in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This. A dentist uniform. I saw it last week. Didn't think twice.
Thank you.
just crashed into the Rose Bowl. Is it true the chef is decorating the senior prom?
Yes, yes, it's all true now, please.
There's another big hot shot looking for you, Seymour. Not proud. He's been asking all over where to find you. Seymour, don't think.
Is that him?
That's him, Mr. Morrison.
Thank you, Gerald. Seymour Provost, sweetie, honey, baby, pussy cat.
Do I know you?
Oh, of course I'll see you. Gonna be happy when you do.
Thank you.
if life were tawdry and impoverished as before, she might not like me, she might not want me. Without my plan, she might not love me any more. That I was just a nothing again, a nobody. Would you still like me?
Yeah, I still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
No, it's settled. My God!
And bullets, and rat poison, and a machete. Tomorrow morning, right after Life magazine takes our pictures, you know who. Bites the dust.
Seymour!
Right. They'll take my picture. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV job. And we'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more knife beatings. No more squalling for blood.
Hey, what blood? I don't get it, Seymour. You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be afraid of, Audrey. I'll take you away. It's that nice little development you always dreamed about. And we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house. Nice little car, and no plants. No plants at all.
You're talking so cute here, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow, Audrey. Just go home now, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Ow!
Ooh, feed me!
Under no circumstances.
Beat me!
I will not, so stop asking.
Beat me!
Look, I can't take much more of this. How about a
run down the corner and get you some nice chopped sirloin. Maybe that'll hold you till the Life magazine gets here.
No way.
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done. Fine. Great. And don't expect dessert.
This could be bigger than hula hoops.
bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger!
Every household in America, thousands of you eating. That's what you've had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock!
We're not talking about one hungry planet here. We're talking about world conquest!
And I want to thank you!
You wanted to eat the only thing I ever loved!
Too bad!
Here, take this, and this, and this, and this, and this!
I give up, Grubhorn.
Never! Here! Eat this!
Uh-oh.
It's all over now.
Thank you. The cats were as follows. Seymour Crowborn was played by Simon Prey.
Let's stop. Thank you very much to all the cast. Actually, in a moment, I'd like one or two people just to come up here, actually. James, if you could come up a minute, and Kelly, come up here. Yeah, that's right, here. If you can make your way out, just come around. Yeah. And we've got the girls. Could you come up here a minute? And Ben, let's come over here. Okay. Katie? Kerry? Becky, Simon? Okay. These guys have been absolutely amazing, I've got to say that, in the last couple of weeks. They've really, really helped. The whole thing, guys, they've been really good. And I've got just something they can remember the show by, so please hang on a second. For Lil, wherever you are. Where's Lil? This is for Katie. Can I thank you all for coming and supporting Southampton Community College's production. We hope you'll come and support next year's. Maybe we'll do it for four nights next year. But come on the first night as well, and you can come on the last night again, you know. Alright? Thank you very much and good night. Thank you.
Easy, I'm not sure.